If you're familiar with masking, then you know at times it can be a long, boring, and downright painful experience. So in an effort to put some joy back into masking, I have compiled three awesome and fast masking effects that you can do regardless of your skill level. And speaking of awesome things, this video is sponsored by Soundstripe. So more about them at the end of the video. Now, let's get into it. So our first masking effect is the masking door transition. In DaVinci Resolve, I have my two clips. The door opening, and I have my second location. So what I'll do first is actually speed ramp the door opening. So I'll find when my door is actually opening, and then I'm gonna right click and go to retime controls. Then just hit this drop down arrow right here to add a speed point. Now once that's done, grab this blue tab on the top and drag it down ever so slightly to speed it up to roughly 130% or so. Now I'll bring my first clip onto the second video layer and then put my second clip under the first clip a little bit. So now go down to the color tab right here. In the color tab, find the place where your door is actually starting to open, and we wanna make sure that we're actually keeping track of our mask movement. So I'm gonna go down to the tracker tab, and because I don't want my mask changes to affect the whole clip, I'm just gonna change this from clip to frame. So after that, I'm gonna move forward a few frames and mask out the room until our mask completely fills the whole frame. Then I'm gonna move back and make sure that my mask actually lines up with the edge of the door like it's supposed to. So just make any changes you need to. So once that's done, I'm gonna right click on the node graph and select add alpha output. Then I'm just gonna connect the alpha outputs together, but clearly this is all wrong right here. So I'll go down to the window tab and I'm just gonna invert it on the pen tool that I used by just hitting the button right there. Now it is the correct way. I'm gonna go back to the tracker tab and change it from frame to clip. And then I'll switch to the windows tab and then turn off the power window. Once we've done that, you can actually see how harsh this mask is. And it is pretty ugly, like don't look at it. So I'll just bring up the softness ever so slightly until it just blends together all nice and stuff. Once we've done that, I'm gonna switch to my second clip and we're gonna blur the background a bit because otherwise it's just gonna look super unnatural. I mean, our door isn't even in focus. So under effects, I'm gonna go and type in Gaussian blur and drag it onto the node right here. Now, I really like how this 400% looks right here, like a lot. So I'm gonna put a keyframe halfway in the door swing, just right here. Then I'll move all the way to the end of our first clip where our door is fully open, and I'm gonna drag down the blur all the way. So by doing this, it's just gonna add that cherry on top and pull the whole effect together and look all nice and seamless and stuff. So now moving on to the second effect, I'm gonna show you how to actually put reflections in people's glasses, because that's dope. Now the first thing I'm gonna do is just go straight into the Fusion tab. And speaking of the Fusion tab, we have some more Fusion videos coming soon. So be sure to subscribe and turn on the bell notifications for that. So hit Control and Spacebar to bring up the Select Tools menu, add in the tracking node, and then we're gonna take our tracking point and put it on a high contrast area like this. So I'm gonna actually go ahead and add one more tracker for safety. So just hit the add button right here and move the tracking point to another high contrast point. Now under adaptive mode, I'm gonna select best match and then just drag the tolerance down a bit. Then I'm gonna hit track forward and DaVinci Resolve is just gonna do its thing right there. Once it's done tracking, I'm gonna grab the B-spline mask and drag it below. And before I connect it to anything at all, I'm just gonna mask out her eye. So once you do that, drag in the second video clip that we want to reflect inside of our lenses. It could be literally anything. Now grab the output of the media in and connect it to the end of the tracker just like this. And that's where merge nodes come from. Then I'm gonna make another merge node by connecting the media in one to the merge one that we just created a minute ago. And then there's another merge node. Now grab the B-spline node and connect it to the blue alpha input on merge two. So now we have a floating eye in cyberspace. This is happening because our eye is connected to the foreground input of the merge instead of the background. So we're gonna have to ultimately just switch those two things. And it's actually super simple. What we're gonna do is click merge two and then hit Control T on the keyboard to just switch the two inputs. And now that we've done that, we have to actually connect our tracking data to the mask so that we keep this cyberspace thing inside of her lenses. So I'm gonna click on the B spline and then right click on our center and select connect to tracker one and then unsteady position. And for some reason, my mask actually moves off a bit. I don't actually know why. So just highlight it all, move it back into line, and yeah, it's kind of annoying, but if anyone actually knows why it does that, let me know. Now I'm gonna go ahead and make it look a little bit more believable. So I'm gonna click on the merge one and go down to apply mode and then select screen. Then I'm gonna bring down the blend like this and then I'm gonna hit control spacebar and add in a soft glow right here. Bring down the threshold just a little bit like this. Then bring down the gain a little bit too. Really just play around with it until it looks good for your shot. Anyway, the last thing that I'm gonna do is make this slight lens distortion look that glasses actually make. So I'm gonna pull up my select tools menu and grab the lens distortion node and add it right in. Then I'll bring the distortion down so that it looks like it's actually kind of curving with her lenses. Then under position, I'm going to right click and go to connect to tracker one, and could you guess the last one? Unsteady position. So now the lens reflection is gonna actually stay lined up to her lens, you know, like normal lenses do. Now moving on to our third and final effect, the object removal effect. So this is to remove any kind of surface imperfections in your footage. Now, for example, this road patch right here, that is messing up my road. So let's hop into Fusion. The first thing that you'll do is grab the transform node right here, and then you're gonna grab the output of your transform and bring it back to the media in one. So I'll grab the polygon node and add it in. And with it selected, I'm gonna draw a mask around this ugly patch in my otherwise beautiful road. Then we can go up to the transform node and under center Y, just move it down a bit. And you can see that this road patch actually is just gone. However, of course, you can see that there is a hard edge to it. So if we go down to the polygon one node, all we're gonna do is bring up the soft edge ever so slightly so that it actually just blends together perfectly. Once we blend that all nice and stuff, we need to track it. We're gonna go back to the beginning, bring up the select tools menu, then type in tracker. Now I'm gonna grab this tracker node and put it right before this media in right here. So if I actually zoom out right here, you can see that we have this tracking point. So I'm gonna put this tracker in my left viewer. Now just place the tracker on that ugly patch. Once we do that, go up to adaptive mode and hit best match. Then bring down the tolerance a bit. So hit track forward from the current time and then let DaVinci Resolve do its thing. Now, once we have that tracked, I will view my media out by hitting two on the keyboard. And then under polygon one, I'm gonna right click under center and go to connect to tracker one and then unsteady position. So if I go back to the beginning now, you can see that our mask actually is staying where I want it to. Yeah, I like that a lot. And you wanna know what else I like a lot? Our sponsor, Soundstripe. I can honestly say that Soundstripe has an incredible library of curated high quality music. Plus they have like 55,000 high quality sound effects and they're actually worth using. Now what really sets them apart is that regardless of the plan that you pick, the license covers unlimited personal and commercial projects. You can use it on a YouTube video like this or a TV show or even a movie. Plans start at $12.50 a month for unlimited music downloads with permanent commercial licensing. So that means if you cancel, any song that you used while you were subscribed is completely covered forever. As a little bonus, you can get 20% off of any plan, even the annual plan, if you use the code BILLY20. And thank you, Soundstripe, for sponsoring this video. And also, thank you. We just hit 100K subscribers on this channel. It is completely mind-blowing. Like, I have, thank you. Like, this is crazy. Like, I genuinely can't fathom 100,000 people. Like, you guys have no idea. So we have a 100K video coming soon, so be sure to subscribe for that. And if you want more masking effects, then check this video out. My name is Billy, and I'll catch you in the next one. Peace.